Today we're going to go ahead and do a quick review on the Bushnell Trophy TRS 25 Red Dot. This is actually made for rifle, shotgun, or handgun. I actually picked this up from Cabela's recently. I think our retail price is roughly around $100. It was on sale there for, I believe, $69.99. About 75 bucks out the door with tax. This is a 3 MOA dot. It does use a CR2032 battery, which you can obviously get from anywhere, CVS, Home Depot, pretty much any other type of electronic store. It is waterproof and fogproof up to 10 feet. It's got 11 different positions for brightness. Let's go ahead and open this up. So this is what's included in the box. Have a warranty card, I believe. A registration card, give a nice little microfiber pad, have a nice little manual here, English, Italian, and Spanish, I'm sure. Comes in a really nice packaging as well, nice padded foam. The bottom, unfortunately, is not padded, so obviously if there is any shock or if it does get moved up and down, there's no padding on there, but from my experience, these are really, really nice red dots, and they can definitely take a beating. I'll see if I can zoom in here. Okay, so this is the sight right here, the optic. Pretty basic. Now, when you get this out of the bag, or out of the box, the battery's actually already going to be in there. They give you some nice bikini covers here. Really nice and durable. Even though it is made in China, it's actually pretty decent quality. So let's go ahead and turn this on here. So this is actually going to the front of your rifle. And then obviously this is what you're looking through. I'll see if I can turn this on here and show you guys the display. Let's go to 3 here. See if I can show you guys the dot. There's a dot right there. And like I mentioned before, when you do actually receive this, the battery will actually already be installed. It's actually not that difficult to turn on or turn off. It's made pretty solid. Now, in order to get access to the battery, it's actually on the brightness setting here. So this cover right here, you can actually use like a quarter or a screwdriver, but there's actually some grip here on the top of the cover. Just use your fingers. Go ahead and unscrew. And there's your battery right there. Really simple design. It's got a rubber O-ring there, so if you do drop it in the water, pick it up quickly and it should still be good to go. I'm pretty sure in the rain there's not going to be any issues with that. And there's actually two covers for the windage and elevation dials here. Made out of aluminum, so it's not that heavy, fairly light. And basically, in order to adjust the windage and elevation, you will actually need maybe like a multi-tool or a flathead screwdriver to adjust that. Let's see if I can show you guys here. So that is left and right. And the top is up and down. Weaver Picatinny rail, you're good to go. Just a heads up for you folks who have an AR type of platform, you will actually need to get at least a 1-inch high riser mount for this in order to co-witness with your irons. I actually got one without a high riser since it's actually going to be installed on the AK. So what I'm going to do right now is mount it on and give you guys a example how it looks.